Hi, I'm Stacy from c3 Controls, and today we're going to enhance your application by using miniature circuit breaker accessories. A standalone miniature circuit breaker is just a current dependent switch. When tripped, it'll turn itself off, interrupting power in case of an overload or short circuit. When used in a control panel or in process equipment, a miniature circuit breaker can offer much more than just current protection. It's capable of remote tripping, status indication, undervoltage, overvoltage protection, and much more. For all of these functions, there are specific accessories which turn a single-purpose miniature circuit breaker into a multi-purpose assembly. Commonly used accessories are auxiliary contact, alarm auxiliary, shunt trip module, undervoltage overvoltage module, and lock-off attachment. All of these accessories attach easily to the miniature circuit breaker and provide a great level of functionality for control and automation applications. Let's see how these accessories are useful one by one. First, let's start with the auxiliary contact. This accessory allows remote indication of the status of a miniature circuit breaker or supplementary protector to which it's connected. Simply put, it helps identify whether the circuit breaker is open or closed remotely. Apart from the remote status indication, there can be multiple use cases for this accessory. Here's one example. Consider this circuit, a motor actuator circuit using a contactor. In this circuit, whenever there's a fault, short circuit or overload, at the power circuit, the miniature circuit breaker will cut off the supply to the motor and protect it from the fault. But when you look at the control circuit, you can see that the contacts remain closed, continuing to supply voltage to the contactor coil unnecessarily. In this diagram, it demonstrates the use of an auxiliary contact along with a miniature circuit breaker in a control circuit. Here you can see that the contactor will also be turned off during a fault, eliminating energy waste. Now let's move on to the alarm auxiliary. The alarm auxiliary accessory indicates when a miniature circuit breaker or supplementary protector is tripped. A trip can be the result of an overload, short circuit, operation of a shunt trip accessory, or an undervoltage overvoltage module. Unlike a standard auxiliary, the alarm auxiliary will change its contact state only in the case of tripping. Its contacts can be used in the actuation circuit of audible alarm or visual indication, which will signal the operator about the fault in the system. These contacts could also be used in digital input arrangement for use in a SCADA system. Now let's move on to the shunt trip module. The shunt trip module is used to remotely trip the miniature circuit breaker or supplementary protector to which it is attached and cut off the power to any equipment or machine connected to them. This accessory will make the miniature circuit breaker or supplementary protector trip when it receives the designated control voltage across its terminals. An ideal application would be an emergency stop circuit. Whenever it is required to turn off the equipment supply, pushing the emergency switch will power up the shunt coil, causing the breaker to trip. Now let's move on to the undervoltage overvoltage module. As previously mentioned, a standalone miniature circuit breaker provides protection only against overcurrent and short circuits. When an undervoltage overvoltage module is used, it will trip the miniature circuit breaker or supplementary protector in the event of the applied voltage across its coil terminals is out of the specified band. In short, the undervoltage overvoltage module is useful for protection against voltage dips and swells. Once supply recovers to normal, only then can the breaker be turned on. This accessory provides cost-effective and easy way to implement this solution. In this circuit, the undervoltage coil is continuously energized, thus keeping the miniature circuit breaker on. When it is to be turned off, opening the contacts of the e-stop will interrupt the coil supply, as it is out of the specified band. Finally, let's move on to the lock-off attachment. In some situations, it is absolutely necessary that only an authorized person should switch the miniature circuit breaker to the on state after a trip. For example, during panel maintenance, when the supply is cut off, a lock-off attachment is placed on the circuit breaker along with the padlock to prevent unauthorized access and an undesired or harmful event. In conclusion, when the miniature circuit breaker functionality is expanded with the use of these accessories, the value of the miniature circuit breaker is increased, making application realization easy and cost-effective. C3 Controls now offers most of the accessories which attach seamlessly to its UL49 miniature circuit breakers and UL1077 supplementary protectors. Along with IP20 finger safe protection, these accessories are UL listed for guaranteed safety of your panel and your personnel. Visit c3controls.com for more information. Thanks and have a great day.